forward at 7'3" from Latvia, number 6, Kristaps Porzingis.
Nice booing. Everyone's smiling in the clips. Porzingis is smiling. I expect more from you, New York. Welcome back to The Jump. You just heard, of course, what it sounded like when Kristaps Porzingis returned to Madison Square Garden for the first time last night as an opponent. Some boos, some chitter chatter. Spike was there. Kristaps finished the game with 20 points and 11 rebounds, but he started kind of shaky. And here's Marcus Morris, who was, of course, the hero of the game with his three-pointer. Here's what he had to say.
It was another level, and, you know, it looked like it was a little rattled too, so, you know, it kind of helped us.
In the beginning, yeah, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Brian, Marcus Morris Sr. is never at a loss for words when it comes to trying to tell his opponent what he thinks of him. Did you agree that Kristaps was rattled last night?
I do think at the start of the game he was rattled. He, right out of the gate, he tried to make a steal out of their defensive scheme. And then he forced a shot maybe on the Mavericks' second or third possession. And I've been around guys in these situations, and they just, how could you not be tight? Of course you're going to be tight. And, you know, he's not played the way that he would like to play. I think it was a bit of a disservice that they had the schedule, had him play both of these games in his first month back from ACL. On the other hand, they're over now.
Right.
You know, so he has not played his best. He also wasn't a factor down the fourth quarter last night, which is not the first time we've seen this from him this year, which is probably a bigger topic for the Mavericks than just last night's game.
He was rattled. Matter of fact, KP always looked rattled. It's not the first time. He's always rattled. And he's, I mean, you know, obviously he hasn't been horrible, but he haven't lived up to expectations.
He didn't have a terrible game. He just didn't have a great game. He didn't have a good game.
But we are waiting on that great game.
But aren't we giving him the same space that we gave Gordon Hayward, that we gave Paul George?
Absolutely not, Rachel. I had a torn ACL. I came back in 6 or 7 months, and it was no excuse.
Okay? Not everyone is you, Kendrick Perkins.
No, but I'm not as talented as Porzingis. But, I mean, he had 20 months to rehab. That's more than enough time to come back in great fashion. And he's posting all these IG, Instagram, you know, I done bulked up and all this, and he still haven't touched the block one time. So, I mean, I'm just not high on Porzingis. I'm sorry. So, I'm with Marcus Morris. I mean, he looked
I actually don't think he should go to the block, Perk, because I don't think he can play down there right now. Maybe later in his career, but I actually think he should stay on the outside. That's kind of worried.
What? Well, wow.
Which is tough at that position.
Right. Well, it's tough when you're 7'3". I understand.
Limiting.
Don't go to the block. Yeah, right. 7'3". That's not down. Well, don't go to the paint.
I mean,
you don't have the jump to dunk. Don't go and touch the paint.
I don't think that's where he's excelling.
I mean, we know how he got hurt in the first place, so.
That's true.
There you go. How do you feel he did it? It wasn't even Turtleneck Tuesday, and he had the turtleneck going.
I'm just guessing. I have no information. My guess is that outfit was planned long in advance, that this was a big night for him, and he did win on that one.
He did.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports analysis and highlights, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.